And I would like to play a little tune I just composed not so long ago.
Miss Billie Holiday.
The music called jazz. It's rooted in the sounds of the African. Or should I say the mother? Bringing us back again. From the drumming on the Congo, we came with a strong flow and continued to grow. Feet moved to the beat of the tabalo. Now dig the story and follow. For then it landed on American soil. Through the sweat, the blood, and the toil. It praised the Lord, shouted on chain gangs. Pain they felt, but it helped them to maintain. Scott Joplin grass, Bessie Smith's blues, St. Louis blues, they were all the news, ringing smooth in all the listeners' ears, fulfilling the needs and planting the seeds of a jazz band. King Oliver's group was a train coming through to Chicago, bringing a New Orleans groove. And with Satchmo Blue, the audience knew Basin Street Blues was the whole house tune. It was music great to dance to, great to romance to, with a lot to say to you, relaying a message, revealing the essence of a jazz fan. First bebop, the real bebop. So let me talk about Diz and Bird, giving the word, defining how a beat could be so complete. Playing with ferocity, thinking with velocity, about ornithology or anthropology, and even epistrophe, and this is real history. Thelonious Monk, a melodious thunk. No mistakes were made with the notes he played. His conception was recondite, a star glowing bright among dim lights. The critics did cite that he sounded all right, and Charlie Mingus, such nimble fingers, dropping the bass all over the place. And Max Roach, cymbal socking, bass drum talking, snare drum rocking, restructuring the metaphysics of a jazz thing. John Coltrane, a man supreme, he was the cream. He was the wise one, the impression of Afro blue and of the promise that was not kept. He was a giant step, and there was one at Coleman. He was another soul man, the original invisible, playing great music. I wonder why the bankers couldn't use it. Now listen, see, the real mystery is how music history created by white men or any other white man and pretended he originated and contended that he innovated a jazz thing.
Course we know who could really blow,
scheming on the meaning of a jazz thing. And this music ain't dead, so don't be misled by those who said that jazz is on its deathbed. Cause when Betty Carter sings this song, ain't nothing going on but simply good music, and you won't refuse it. She's taking her time making the nuances rhyme. Sonny Rollins, tenor saxophone with a big old tone, reciting poems with notes as words. And haven't you heard? Next stop butter, right past Olio. Now there's young cats blowing, and more people, yes, they will be knowing. Jazz ain't the past, this music's gonna last. And as the facts unfold, remember who foretold the 90s will be the decade of a jazz thing.
I love jazz music.
A jazz thing.
I love jazz music.
A jazz thing.
I love jazz music. I love jazz music.
A jazz thing.
I would like to play a little tune I just composed not so long ago.
Miss Billie Holiday.
The music called jazz.
Thank you, great Charlie Parker, the one and only.
Thank you.
A man of jazz.
Thank you.
In the sounds of the African, or should I say the mother, bringing us back again from the drumming on the Congo. It came with a strong flow and continued to grow. Feet moved to the beat of the tabalo. Now dig the story and follow, for then it landed on American soil. Through the sweat, the blood, and the toil, it praised the Lord, shouted on chain gangs. Pain they felt, but it helped them to maintain. Scott Joplin's rags, Bessie Smith's blues, St. Louis blues, they were all the news, ringing smooth in all the listeners' ears, fulfilling the needs and planting the seeds of a jazz band. King Oliver's group was a train coming through to Chicago, bringing a New Orleans groove. And when Satchmo blew, the audience knew Basin Street Blues was the whole house tune. It was music, great to dance to, great to romance to, with a lot to say to you, relaying a message, revealing the essence of a jazz band. In the 40s came bebop, the first bebop, the real bebop. So let me talk about Diz and Bird, giving a word, defining how a beat could be so complete. Playing with ferocity, thinking with velocity, about ornithology or anthropology, and even epistrophe. And this is real history, the loneliest monk, a melodious thump. No mistakes were made with the notes he played. His conception was recondite, a star glowing bright among dim lights. The critics did cite that he sounded all right. Charlie Mingus, such nimble fingers, dropping the bass all over the place. And Max Roach, cymbal socking, bass drum talking, snare drum rocking, restructuring the metaphysics of a jazz thing.
That's who we'd like you to feel, that you've just walked in. You've been seated at the table, and now you're ready to listen to
John Coltrane, a man supreme. He was the cream, he was the wise one, the impression of Afro blue and of the promise that was not kept. He was a giant step. And there was Ornette Coleman, he was another soul man, the original invisible, playing great music. I wonder why the bankers couldn't use it. Now listen, see, the real mystery is how music history created Paul Whiteman or any other white man, and pretended he originated, and contended that he innovated a jazz thing.
Of course, the three eyes know who can really blow.
Scheming on the meaning of a jazz thing. The jazz is on its deathbed, 'cause when Betty Carter sings a song, ain't nothing going on but simply good music, and you won't refuse it. She's taking her time making the nuances rhyme. Sonny Rollins, tenor saxophone with a big old tone, reciting poems with notes as words. And haven't you heard?
Big stop butter, right past oleum.
And now there's young cats blowing, and more people, yes, they will be knowing. Jazz ain't the past, the music's gonna last. And as facts unfold, remember who foretold the 90s will be the decade of a jazz thing. 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 Jazz band. A jazz band. A jazz band. A jazz band. A jazz band.